Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Get Started with Jenkins series. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can install Jenkins. Just a quick note before I continue. The instructions in this video will only work for Linux distributions that are based on Debian. Jenkins can run on practically all Linux distributions, but for this video, I will use Ubuntu Server 15.10. If you prefer to use another Linux distribution, you can skip this video and check out the official Jenkins documentation and read the instructions for your distribution. Okay, so with that out of the way, let's get going. I'll start by showing you how you can install the open source version of Java JRA and JDK. I'm not going to use the Oracle installation because the Jenkins documentation specifically recommends OpenJDK. Afterwards, we're going to add the Jenkins apt-get repository to our system and then install Jenkins itself. So let's get going. Okay, so here I am logged into my Ubuntu Server installation, and the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to install the JDK and the JRA, the Java Development Kit and the Java Runtime Environment. So to do this, I'm going to run sudo apt-get install and then OpenJDK 7, which is the recommended version, JRA. I'm going to type in my password and I'm going to say yes to downloading all these dependencies. Now this is going to take some time, so I'm going to speed up this video and get back to you when it's finished. Okay, so that's probably the fastest install of a JRA that you've ever seen. And now we're going to continue by installing the development kit for Java. So I'm going to run sudo apt-get install once more, and this time I'm going to install OpenJDK 7 JDK. And again, I'm going to say yes to downloading and installing these dependencies, and I'll speed up this video once more. Okay, so now that Java is installed, we can check if it's installed correctly. And I can run java-version to see the current version, which is 1.7, it's Java 7. So Java is installed correctly. Now the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to add the security key for the Jenkins apt-get repository to our system. I'm going to take a little cheat sheet here with some commands, and I'm just going to copy the first command, which downloads the key and adds it to our system. So this is wget, which downloads this URL, saves it to our disks, and then gives that key, it pipes it to the apt-key add command. So I'm going to run this command, I'm going to give it my password, and there we go, the key has been added to our system. Now the next step is to add the URL of the Jenkins repository to our sources list. So that's what the second command does. So I'm going to copy this here as well, paste it in here. So this echoes this text, dep, http, then the address, into the Jenkins.list file. So if I hit enter, boom, that's done. And now all that's left is running sudo apt-get update to update our list of packages. And finally, we can install Jenkins by running sudo apt-get install Jenkins. Again, it asks me to download all these dependencies. I'm going to say yes. And once more, I'll be fast-forwarding this video for you. And there we go. Jenkins is now installed, and we can actually verify that it's running because when you install Jenkins, it automatically starts up the service. So if I go to Safari and I navigate to the IP address of my server and I add port 8080 to it and I hit enter, sure enough, there is my Jenkins instance already up and running. So that's it for this video. In the next video, I'll show you how you can import source code from Git repositories straight into Jenkins. Thank you very much for watching this video, and be sure to subscribe to my channel or follow me on Twitter if you like this video.